Have you ever been, in your career, that poor employee yourself?
Oh, many times. Screamed at, pushed, kicked. Once I was spat on. I lived in France for 3 years, and I worked for the most amazing chefs. When you are 21 years of age, working in one of the best restaurants in the world, standing in Paris, no money, keen to learn, and you've got a great chef's reputation in your hands, if you make a mistake, you're going to hear about it. So it's the nature of the beast. Unfortunately, like I said, that level of perfection, they give you that trust, you let them down, man, you're going to get it.
How do you respond to that yourself?
I keep my mouth shut. I was 21, 22 years of age. The good news for me, whilst getting my ass kicked in France, was they were screaming at me, and it was all in French, so I had no idea what they were saying. But like if you told me off in your language and you were screaming at me, I'd think that... Or you're Swedish, perhaps. Yeah?
But you have to feel it.
You want to try it?
Yeah.
What, like...
You felt it even though...
Oh, I can just tell the expression on your face when you're pissed off.
So what would be your first memory in life with food?
My first memory in life is a really good question, that. Would be my mother's bread and butter pudding. Because we didn't grow up with lots of money, Freddie. We it was a humble insight. We moved around a lot. Dad was always losing his job, and every time he got a new job, it came with a house. We lost his job. We moved the family around. So, bread and butter pudding, but beautifully done with stale bread, custard, sultanas, and then sometimes as a treat, Mum would put over the top, just under the grill, a little splash of Scottish whiskey. And you 2-3 tablespoons of that, man, you're sleeping for 10 hours.
So she was kind of the inspiration.
Mum was a cook and a nurse. She worked as a nurse in the evening, and she worked as a cook in a restaurant in Stratford-on-Avon during the day. So the food that didn't sell in the restaurant, she used to bring home. We used to eat that, and then Mum would cook, reheat, and then go back off to work. She had two jobs. An amazing cook.
But you never considered nurse for yourself?
Me as a nurse? Are you serious?
What do you think of picky eaters?
A pain in the ass. Do you know what upsets me more than anything? What? It's sometimes when my mum comes to the restaurant. A, you can't give her the bill, because you can't do that to your mum, right? Mm-hmm. Secondly, she wants her meat well done. So I cringe. But what upsets me...
For you, that's ruined food.
Yeah, it's like eating a flip-flop or a piece of shoe. Why go for Aberdeen Angus well done when if you just serve it pink with some juice and flavour, Freddie, it's delicious?
Exactly.
Anna, you agree?
Yeah.
Excellent.
Absolutely.
High five,
man. What do you think of vegetarians?
I'm allergic to vegetarians.
Oh, I see.
I come out in a rash and my skin starts getting irritated. Truthfully, I have 4 children, 3 girls and a boy. Amazing
And
kids.
You wouldn't allow them to be vegetarians?
But I pay them never to become a vegetarian. So my youngest, Matilda, said, Dad, if you don't buy me those new Dr. Martens for Christmas, I promise you, I'm going to become vegetarian. Terrible. Honestly, I mean, you know, there's a level of protein that we all need, and there's a level of, you know, starch that we need in terms of daily balance. So it really makes chefs work a little bit harder to create vegetarian food to become just as exciting as your normal food on the menu. But yeah, vegetarians, ooh.
Hope you enjoyed the clip. For more interesting conversations, please hit subscribe.